Now we're in RasterLink. We've already imported our file, as you can see, with our red registration mark boxes. We're going to right-click on it and go into our Edit menu to bring up the job editor. And then we've got it centered, and we can see closely now that we have our red registration boxes behind our marks. In your print condition, we're going to make sure that we have the SS color set selected, which is going to allow us to print with our white ink. Now we can go to our Color Edit tab and go to Special Color Adjustment. And there we can go to Special Color Composition and select our Special Color Overprint to print with our special color, white, and then our color on top of it. You can set our quality level. I usually use level 3. And then for this specific image, I want to do my composition as valid pixel, and I only want a very light tint of white. Now this is where our problem with our registration marks comes from, because that little amount of white won't create enough contrast for the registration mark sensor to actually pick up the marks. What we need to do is have a high contrast of white just behind where our marks are so that we can actually print and cut this object. We can go into our color replacement to do that. In color replacement, we need to create a new color replacement. We already have one. I've called it registration marks or reg marks. What I can do is find my color here, and it'll bring up, once I click on it, it'll bring up the CMYK color value. I'm going to replace that with 100% of my two special colors, which are both white, and then at that point I would hit setup. This will create our color selection here to take this CMYK value to the other CMYK value of simply 200% white channels. I'll update this to select it and click on OK. As you can see in this photo example, we've got both a really dark registration mark box, so we've got a lot of contrast, and then we've got a very translucent image with a very light amount of white behind it.
Hope that's been helpful, and we'll see you next time.